Want to know more about printmaking? Meet local printmaker Acadia Kandora. In this studio visit, Acadia will tell us about her artwork, why she makes prints, and how she creates them.
Hello everyone, my name is Acadia Kandora. I'm a graduate student here at the University of Arkansas, and I'm a printmaker. I make work about the natural landscape, my connection to nature, and the intersection between the imaginary and the concrete. I take landscapes that come out of my head, landscapes that exist in the world, and I push and pull and merge them together and examine how I interact with them to make my work. And I make this work to talk about climate change, to talk about how important it is to protect the forests and our surrounding nature, because it's really important and I'm super passionate about that. So I first heard about printmaking at a really young age, mostly because my grandmother was a printmaker. She used to make all of these engravings done on zinc plates. Even though my grandmother was a printmaker, she didn't really show me that much about printmaking. I've actually still never done an etching to this day. And it wasn't until I got into college, specifically later in college, that I really started making prints. And now I'm studying printmaking in graduate school, which is really fun. And I can finally focus in the media area that I really want, that I'm really passionate about and wanted to concentrate in. This is my graduate studio. It's located inside the larger print shop, but I'm gonna show you all around. Here's my shelf of oddities that I've either made or found, mostly rocks and natural stuff. Some of them are made of cast resin, and others are 3D printed, and some are just found, or in one of these cases, made from paper. When I go out into nature, I usually collect rocks or pine cones, and I bring back things about my journey and whatnot, and I leave all this stuff in my studio, mostly because it's inspirational to me, and I think it's really important as a maker to have things that you're inspired by that you can reference right here. My desk right now is a bunch of the books I've been working on. I've been working on a series of publications about nature, and here are some of the most recent editions. I play with folding them in unique ways, printing them. Yeah, I'm super excited about this box of books. So now I'm going to show you the larger print shop. I'm going to put this on because it's a public space. But here we go. So down these hallways are my peer spaces, and this is the larger print shop. So this is my favorite piece of equipment in the print shop. It is an etching press, and essentially what you do is you have your inked up plate on the press bed and you spin the wheel, and as the plate goes under this rolling drum, it applies literal tons of pressure that transfers the ink from your plate to the paper.
This is the print shop's fine selection of rollers and brayers. This one is my absolute favorite. It's super fun, love it. But yeah, this is how we get the ink on the block evenly.
So this is a 5-layer woodblock print. I engraved it on the laser cutter and made a jig for each plate to fit into. Each plate is inked up in a different color and printed on top of each other in order of either light to dark or background to foreground. Here are my plates. And here is the building of the image, layer by layer.
So lately, I've been working on a series of nature publications that examine my relationship to nature. This woodblock print is one of the illustrations in a book that I'm working on about my garden. During the first few months of COVID, I stayed inside my apartment like most of us did, isolated and anxious. But I found myself longing for nature and being outside. So I ended up making an apartment balcony garden. It was a symbiotic relationship. I took care of the plants and made sure they had water and nutrients, and in return, they nourished my mental state. This book is about that relationship as the plants in my garden are growing with and on top of me.
So my advice for anyone who wants to learn more about printmaking and potentially do a lot of printmaking would be to first never stop making. Always be thinking, drawing, writing things down. I consider hiking part of my studio practice. I think consistently and constantly flooding your mind with inspiration is really important. Secondly, I would say experiment. If you have access to ink, make some prints. You can literally print anything. I've seen people print onions, leaves. You can glue stuff to a cardboard plate and ink it up and run it through either a press or rub it by hand. And that's called a collagraph. That's a type of printmaking, and that's a collage of found materials. Look around you and be very observant, because almost everything you interact with on a day-to-day basis is a print. The cereal box that you poured cereal out for breakfast, that's a print. The newspaper. And I think really seeing the world through that kind of lens, I think it's super important and can really help.
Thanks for joining us. Be sure to watch the other printmaking videos on this page to learn how to make prints of your own and continue creating together.